consulting with the session on ledger account. Today I'm going to discuss about the meaning of ledger account and few points we need to remember at the time of preparing the ledger account. So we'll go with the meaning of ledger account. Ledger account is a summary of all the transactions relating to a person, asset, expenses or income which have taken place during a given period of time showing the net effect. It means to say a ledger account is a very basic concept to know what is my financial status. With the help of these accounts, we can easily find out and we can easily track what is my expense level and how to reduce it. So that is the reason we need to prepare a ledger account. And this ledger account is going to give in detail summary of a statement. So there we can find out how to avoid my expenses and how to increase in my income and how to reduce my all expenses with the help of given information. So here are few points we need to remember. So that is the first one. Separate account has to be opened for each account which are found in journal. So here I'm going to consider journal as a base to prepare my ledger account. In journal account, we are going to pass only the journal entries with the basic concepts, and according to the transaction we are going to pass the journal entry. With the help of that journal we are going to prepare how many accounts we need to prepare and how many personal account, how many nominal and how many real accounts we need to prepare, that we are going to find out in the journal. So in order to prepare my ledger, I'm going to consider journal as my base, and with the help of that I'm going to prepare separate accounts for that. And the second one, debit has to be written on the left side and credit has to be written on the right side of an account. It means to say, so we have to, here we need to apply all golden rules of accounting, that is, I have to go with the personal account rule, real account rule, as well as nominal account rule. So with the help of that, according to that rule, we need to record which one is my debit side and which is my credit side, and this is going to be helpful for to find out my net profit. The third one is, entries posted in the ledger from the journal should be posted on the order the dates. So it means to say according to the dates we are going to post the ledger. Next one is, entries made on the debit side should begin with the word to, and whereas entries made on the credit side begin with the by. The name of an account should not appear either on debit or credit side while posting an entry in the ledger, because a person cannot be a debtor or creditor by himself. Take for example, if I'm going to prepare a capital account, I'm not supposed to write the capital account, because the heads of the account is capital, so we should not write the capital account word in the account. Compound journal entry has to be posted in the same manner. All the ledger account has to be either balanced or closed. And the last one, page number of the journal has to be entered in the journal folio column. And this, here we have an example how to prepare ledger account. The first thing is, with the following transaction prepare ledger account. I'll take the same example. April 1st, Kiran started business with the cash of rupees 10,000 and planned rupees 20,000. We have already passed the journal entry for this. So now we need to prepare a ledger account for this. So this is the ledger account. Here cash is coming in and plant is coming in. If it is coming in, capital belongs to personal account. Debit what? Debit the receiver, credit the giver, and Kiran is the giver. So we have to record by cash account 10,000, by plant account 20,000. Total 30,000 is my commencement of business value. And the second one is bought furniture from Raj. Furniture belongs to real account. Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Here furniture is coming in from Raj account to furniture account 2,000, and the same balance I have to carry down, and the same balance I am going to carry down for this next month or else at the end of the month. Next, goods purchase. Goods is coming in. Purchase account belongs to real account. Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Here goods is coming in. And one more thing is, cash is 6,000 and again we purchased from Vishnu, so that is the reason I have done with the two journal entries, two transactions, 6,500, total is 6,500 is my purchase account value. Like that, so sales value, sales is also belongs to real account, debit what comes in and credit what goes out, goods is going out, our intention is what is going out and what is coming into the business, so that here goods is going out, so by cash and by Rajesh. This is one more journal entry, purchase goods from Vishnu on account. We have to transact whatever we have written in the purchase account, we have recorded on the opposite side of the account. And we have purchase written as well. The balancing figure is my cash account, like that we have saved. Written, purchase written account, sales written account. This is what the ledger account we need to prepare. With the help of this ledger account, we need to pass, we need to prepare P&L account as well as balance sheet. Here we have a summary. We can find out that this is the cash account. We can go with the total value of cash. And this is what the summary, how many accounts we have prepared along with this entry. And one more thing is, here I'm going to prepare, here I have prepared how to pass journal entry and ledger account together, and this they are going to ask for 15 marks. So here we have an example. I'm going to take the same example. So with the help of that example, I'll prepare both journal as well as ledger account. Here we have a journal entry and this is my ledger account. For each account, for each journal entry, I have prepared each account. And this will last for 15 marks. And thank you for listening, and kindly wait for my further content.